Welcome to the Native Mobile Apps Lifecycle session. In this session, we'll be focusing on the application and deployment lifecycle of mobile apps. So we'll discuss how mobile apps are dealt with in lifetime and how we can deploy a mobile app, and what might happen once a mobile app is deployed when it changes. Sometimes we may need to generate a new application package, and other times we may just need to tag a new version. And then we'll also see the type of information we can get about mobile apps in Service Center. So let's go ahead and get started. Mobile apps in lifetime have an application version number. We'll be able to see the modules of those applications, and then there'll be specific versions of the native mobile apps for iOS and Android. And the versions of the native mobile apps can be different for those two types. So when we look at the native mobile app, as we're deploying it, it has a normal application version inside of Out Systems, and then the mobile versions can have a version for Apple and a version for Android. Here we can see it's been generated for Android, but it hasn't been generated for Apple. So when we're deploying a mobile app, the native generated app is not deployed to the destination environment. So in this case, in our development environment, the Android app has already been generated and is ready. So when we go to deploy this and we move 1.2 over to the quality, it says that the Android app needs to be generated, but that it's not configured. So it will not actually move the generated app over. It will just take the configuration of the generated app over, and then it will need to be regenerated over here. So for it to be regenerated, it's going to need configuration information about its key store and other types of information. So we will have to do an extra step after the deployment occurs. Now, sometimes we'll be changing a mobile app. So the mobile app has been published, the native package was already created, and depending on the types of changes, many times those changes are automatically updated, and the application package doesn't need to change at all. But there are some instances where the application package will need to change, and that is if we change the application's name, the entry module itself, the icon or the main color, or we add some type of mobile plugin that's going to access native features, or change the high-level configuration for the mobile platforms. So when we go to publish these types of things, it can give us a warning about changing the mobile app may require it to need to be regenerated. So when we go to tag a version of a mobile app, there will also be the native app versions as well. So lifetime does not allow the tagging of a version of an app without tagging the native build if it already exists. So here in our example, if we've moved up from 1.2 to 1.3 or higher, here we can see that it's changed and we have the plus sign, so we'll be able to tag this to the new version of 1.4. But 0.1 is no longer the active version, so it needs a new version as well. So when we know that there have been changes, we're going to need new tagged versions both of the overall application from an Out Systems perspective and the generated application that will be targeting the specific platform. So when we go to deploy these, if the native app that's configured in the destination environment could be automatically generated, then it will change as far as the deployment stage is concerned. So here, when we're moving from development to QA, if we don't notice any changes and everything is fine, it can actually generate that mobile app. So this has now been scheduled as part of the overall deployment process, and that can happen with all of the new changes when the deployment stage is moved. So last but not least, if we're in Service Center, and we don't have access to Lifetime, there is still information about the native application package that is available in that particular environment. So if we go into our application, we go to the Native Platforms tab, it will show us both an Apple and an Android tab. And in this case, we can see that our Android version is 0.2, and we could go ahead and download that if we needed to. We could go ahead and configure the overall versioning, and if we wanted to regenerate this application, this native application package, we could regenerate it as well. So that's it for the native mobile apps lifecycle and how we'll deal with changing and deploying mobile apps in OutSystems. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.